electric mobility is no longer a science experiment. It's actually a solution. And increasingly, it's a family-friendly one. The Kia Carens Clavis EV may not set your pulse racing like a twin turbocharged V8 would, but what it does is arguably more relevant. It delivers a refined, clean, and cleverly packaged electric experience without asking you to mortgage your sense of taste. Well, that's according to Kia at least. But the Carens Clavis EV actually is a derivative of an ICE platform. But more or so, it is a proof of concept that EVs in India can and should be versatile, usable, and sensibly priced. But does the Clavis EV still carry that all-important MPV functionality? Today, we're going to find out exactly that. So what exactly is this thing? The Kia Carens Clavis EV is Kia's first made-in-India mass-market electric vehicle. It's based on the same architecture as the ICE Carens Clavis, but it is electrified just enough to look convincing. But don't be fooled, it's not a bespoke EV like an EV6 or an EV9 or even the EV3 that's sold globally. It's a platform conversion at the end of the day. But unlike some others, this one hasn't come out the other end feeling like a Frankenstein experiment. There are two battery options, a 42 kilowatt hour battery pack paired to a 133 bhp motor and a larger 51.4 kilowatt hour battery paired with a 169 bhp motor. Now both offer the same amount of torque funnily, which is 255 Nm, and sent exclusively to the front wheels. Claimed range is 404 kilometers for the smaller battery and a frankly optimistic 490 kilometers for the extended range variant. So they have termed it the ER variants. But realistically, shave off around 80 to 100 kilometers, especially if you like using the AC, Google Maps, or drive like you're running late for a parent-teacher meeting. To tell you about the drive, get in, hit the starter, nothing. Welcome to EV land. There is no vibration, no sound, none of that. Throw the throttle and you're immediately greeted by a smooth, torque-rich acceleration, especially in the ER variant with 169 brake horsepower, because there's no gears, there's no drama, just a linear, clean surge of power. The 0 to 100 km per hour on the dash takes around 8.4 seconds, which, let's be honest, is quicker than most people will ever need while carrying three kids, a Labrador, and a drum set in the back. But what's shocking here isn't just the pace, it's the calm. The ride is surprisingly composed. The suspension, McPherson struts up front, and a torsional beam at the back, which has been tuned for the EV variant from the base Clavis because of the additional 200 or 300 kgs of weight that comes with the battery. And the overall experience is tuned to flatten most city undulations and highway ruts without completely detaching you from the tarmac. And yes, there is body roll because it has to exist. It's a tall, heavy people carrier and not a GT4 RS. But overall, it is very controlled and composed. The steering, well, it's there. It exists. It twirls when you ask it to and has a pleasingly light effort input in city use. But don't expect any sort of feedback. What you do get, however, is paddle shifters, and not because it's sporty, but for the regen levels. Now you have four different regen levels with off 1, 2, 3, and you have iPedal mode. The iPedal mode lets you drive the car using your right foot only, because when you lift off the throttle, it just goes into regen and decelerates till you stop. And that happens even on a downhill slope, which makes city driving very easy and clever. At the end of the day, it is a tool, but a rather refined one. At first glance, it still looks like a Carens because, well, it is. The EVification is subtle but clever. The front end ditches the grille for a sleeker cover with aero-active flaps and a neatly integrated charging port on the nose. The illuminated LED DRLs and ice cube fog lamps help it look modern without shouting that I'm an EV. It gets 17-inch aero-optimized wheels on the extended range variants, which don't try to look sporty and are better for range anyway. And there's even a 25-litre frunk. Now, no, it won't hold a suitcase, but maybe a small gym bag or a week's worth of snacks, which, let's face it, is more useful. The 200mm unladen ground clearance is commendable too, and you can clear those infamous Bangalore speed breakers without converting your underbody into an abstract art. The cabin, to borrow Kia's words, is digitally intuitive, which translates to twin 12.3-inch screens that handle everything from navigation to an 8-speaker Bose concert in the cabin. And still in the top-of-the-line variant, you don't get wireless Android Auto or Apple CarPlay. Despite having a wireless charger, you still have to carry to plug in if you want to use either of those. Kia's infamous touch panel that toggles between HVAC and media controls is also present, and yes, it still feels like a cruel joke if you're in a hurry. Material quality is alright. The top-of-the-line HTX Plus ER gets a classy navy and beige combo. Seating is genuinely usable for 6 full-size humans and a smaller 7th one or 3 kids in the third row. The center console gets a new floating design, adding just enough storage to optimize your next road trip. You also get creature comforts like a panoramic sunroof, cool front seats, a power driver's seat, wireless phone charger, and even a retractable tray table. There's also a boss mode, because the only thing better than being driven is mildly oppressing the front passenger seat from behind. Now here's where Kia throws the kitchen sink. Even the base HTKX variant gets disc brakes all around, ESC, hill start assist, TPMS, and 6 airbags. But step to the HTX Plus ER variant that we are driving, and it goes on full sci-fi because it gets level 2 ADAS features, including collision avoidance in every imaginable scenario. You have cars, cycles, pedestrians, and even oncoming traffic in junction turns. Lane keep also is there, along with blind spot monitoring, 360 degree camera, even safe exit warnings, because you have a radar placed at the back as well. There's even a virtual engine sound to warn pedestrians on the outside, because silence while serene is also dangerous. V2L charging is supported too, internal and external as well. So you can power a coffee machine while stuck in a Ladakh traffic jam, or charge someone else's dying EV if you're feeling very generous. Charging is also quick enough using an 11 kilowatt hour AC charger. The 42 kilowatt variant charges from 0 to 100% in 4 hours. While the bigger 51.4 kilowatt hour battery pack takes 4 hours and 45 minutes. DC fast charging up to 100 kilowatt does 10 to 80% in just 39 minutes, which all things considered is respectable. And yes, you also get a 8-year 1.6 lakh kilometer battery warranty, which is again reassuring. So what is this up against? Conventionally, it goes against the BYD E6 and the E-Max 7, which are technically rivals, but at ₹26.9 lakh rupees and above, they are in a different tax bracket. The Clavis EV's closest competitor is its cousin, the Hyundai Creta EV, but you get the same mechanicals, the same platform, the same battery pack, but with additional space and an extra row of seats. So really, the Carens Clavis EV has carved its own niche, with becoming India's only 3-row EV below rupees 25 lakhs. Okay, so here's my verdict. There's a temptation to write this off as just a converted ICE car, but I'd say drive it, live with it, and you will realize that it is far more clever than that. The Carens Clavis EV doesn't pretend to be luxurious or revolutionary. It just wants to be useful, and that frankly is what makes it very cool. And by no means is it a perfect car. It isn't exciting, but it is competent and practical, well equipped, and dare I even say, desirable. This is Kia at its most calculated, but also its most confident. And if this is where mainstream EVs in India are going to look like, I say, bring it on. But what do you guys think? Let us know in the comments below. And thank you for watching BBC Top Gear Magazine India, and we will see you next time.